Hi, my name is Ehsan and I'm the BIM manager and parametric designer in facade engineering. Just a short brief about my background. I have been a facade designer, project manager, BIM manager, and computational designer for the past 10 years. You can see my profile on my LinkedIn for more info about me. Today I'm going to talk about the question, BIM or parametric design. Back in 6 or 7 years ago, parametric design software and the BIM software were completely separated. We had Rhino Grasshopper, that was a great tool for parametric design, and we had Revit software, which was the most famous software for BIM design. But now, most of the software tries to cover the BIM and parametric design, as the world is focusing on both of them. But which one is the most useful for facade designers, BIM or parametric design? Before answering this question, let me talk about parametric design and what parametric design or why parametric design is important for facade designers. Parametric design is the way of designing by parameters, that all these parameters can call as an algorithm and it generate the model automatically through the algorithm. You don't need to draw or modify the object like the classic method one by one. Instead, you design an algorithm and that draw and modify many objects at the same time. Imagine you are designing a 3D curtain wall system. All you need is to design one algorithm for one panel, and the algorithm can make a 3D panel for the whole facade, regardless of the size or shape. You can design your algorithm to accommodate different size and different shapes. So you can speed up your design process for a big project. If you Google parametric design, you will see many big structure and facade system designed by parametric design these days. So parametric design is only about 3D design and which makes the higher speed? The answer is no. We also have a computational design that can be a part of parametric design, and this one will help you to repetitive work, such as the fabrication drawing and shop drawing process. For example, you can see my video for an auto-dimension algorithm that can help the facade team with the glass fabrication drawing in my YouTube channel. The algorithm provides the fabrication drawing of thousands of glasses in some minutes. So with all this benefit of parametric design, should we always stick to parametric design and forget about BIM? No. In fact, parametric design will help the designer of the facade team, but the BIM is mostly about communication between the facade contractor and the other contractor or parties during the construction process. For example, when you have a curtain wall system and some other parties like mechanical team are very close to your curtain wall, to avoid clashes in future, you need to do in BIM format. When you present your 3D design in the BIM format, other parties can see the exact position of your mullion, transom, and it will be a big help to prevent clashes in future. The other reason to use BIM is the cost management and time management for each part of the facade. In the BIM, you can track the cost and time and visualize them in 3D format and track the budget of the work. So I should probably say, we have to use BIM and parametric design, both of them, in facade design. As the world is fast forwarding to the BIM design, which makes the entire process of the construction unify and reduce the error and time and the cost. And the other side, companies are trying to do more big and complex projects. Using BIM and parametric design to achieve more success is a must for facade companies. If you have any comments, please comment on my YouTube channel and let me know what your idea is. And make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel so you will not miss any new video about parametric design and BIM. Thanks for watching.